3-year-old Mpho Ralieta from Katlehong in Ekuruleni, 6-year-old Kale Tumakadla from Dlamini in Soweto, and 6-year-old Komanani Mawe from Orange Farm in the Vaal. These are just three of the many children who have died after falling into open manholes after these incidences. Residents in the city of Joburg and Ekuruleni have been pleading for these holes to be closed and areas to be fenced off where the children play in. These have been the failures of government in deaths that could have been avoided. 3-year-old Mpho fell into a manhole after playing with her friends back in 2006. After the family's loss, the city closed off the open manholes. Kaele Tumakadla suffered the same fate when he too was playing with his friends when he fell into an open manhole. His disappearance brought the country to a standstill. A traumatic 21-day-long search ended in tragedy. It was only during the search that the city sealed off the open manholes. A year after Komanani's death, his family is still reeling from the loss. His father, surprised Mawe, says he blames the city of Joburg for not acting fast enough in closing the open manholes. The 26th of September marks the anniversary of his burial. Before Komanani's death, there were 4 exposed manholes within a 5-kilometer radius. All these deaths later, COJ's Nicholas Bauer now says that pilot projects are the first of many steps in making sure that these exposed manholes are closed.
New manhole covers are being phased in that are made of polymer materials because they contain no metal and are of no value to scrap metal thieves. And we're also piloting a smart manhole cover project, which has a device within it that arms, locks and unlocks, with that information being fed through to a control center and database within the various depots at Johannesburg Water, using GSM technology to send a signal to a central control room. And that is, in essence, going to be able to monitor these manholes.
Last week, Orange Farm residents told Eyewitness News that they want the areas with manholes declared danger zones. Meanwhile, Orange Farm police are still investigating the cause of Komanani's death, and no one has been held liable for leaving these manholes uncovered.